computer systems, it includes first definition that we are going to study about is hardware. Hardware, we all of you know that the physical components or parts of the computer that the user can touch and the user can see. Anybody can see with the and touch, that is called the components of the computer, that is called the hardware. It could be your keyboard, mouse, CPU, scanner, printer, CPU, parts inside the CPU, wires, CD, DVD, hard disk, everything, the parts of the computer, the peripheral devices that we can touch and see, that is called hardware. Software that makes the hardware work, it is a set of instructions that tells the computer what to do, how to do, and how to perform the different operations, where to store the files, how to do the particular task, how to make the computer work, CPU work. All these things are done by the set of instructions which tells the computer to perform the various tasks, because computer itself cannot do any task. The hardware components cannot do any task itself until they get instructions from the user. And the set of instructions that makes a program, and a combination of various programs makes the software. And the software tells the computer how to do the various tasks, how to perform the various tasks. Data means the raw information or facts that we give to computer, that we enter into the computer in the form of data, that means a random figures or random alphabets or some names or some instructions. The information, the facts and figures that we enter into the computer, that is called data. And the processed form of data, that means when the computer performs some processing on the data, that is changes into information. In other words, you can say that it refers to the meaningful data or meaningful information given by the computer after processing the data. Okay. Next is convergence of technology. Convergence of technology means it combining two or more areas or fields of technologies. Koi bhi two areas ko combine karke, when we form a new area, form a new technology, that becomes the convergence of technology. It refers to combining or merging together of two areas or fields or technology. It refers to the process by which the existing technology gets merged into new form that finally brings together various types of media and application. You can learn the definitions also. It is a process by which the already existing technologies, they are combined together to form a new form of technology. They changes into a new form. For example, your mobile games, being the websites on the online, we are combining in the websites, we had combined the text, audio, video, etc., listening music, and various types of convergent technologies, the technologies which have already been convergent, they have been combined, that is computer technology. Computer technology includes hardware and software, both. And it also includes other technologies like processors, memories. That means computer is a combination of hardware, software, processors, memories, and other things. So when we are combining various technology, that is a computer technology. Second is communication technology. Communication technology means it includes the information transfer. When we are transferring the information or passing some information from one place to another, from one machine to another, from one device to another, that is a communication technology. It includes internet, mobile devices, radio, wired or wireless medias, many kind of medias that can be included in the communication technology. Next is ICT. ICT means information and communication technology. It is a combination of information and communication. All the technologies that provide access to information, when we are assessing the information and then we are collecting the information from one different locations and collecting them, that is information. Then communication, because we information passes from one place to one device to another, that is communication. So it is a combination of information technology, that is and communication technology. Content technology, it includes contents linked fields like print, radio, publishing, industry, 3D pictures, live cricket matches, or any other example in which information or content has been included. Okay. So various types of convergence technologies are computer technology, communication technology, ICT, and content technology. Other examples of devices which includes are convergent technologies, that they are smartphones, VoIP, voice over internet protocol, smart TVs, mobile TVs. Devices that includes the convergent of technologies. These are the various technologies, convergent technologies, and these are the devices that has the convert that uses the convergent technologies. Various communication techniques or various communication technologies that we use nowadays is email, SMS, video conferencing. Email means electronic mail. That means the sending and receiving messages from one computer to another or from one device to another via internet. By using the internet, when we transfer some messages, send and receive the messages, that is called email. SMS, that is short message service, full form, and the when one message is sent to another, message is sent from one device to another, from one mobile to another by using the telecommunications, that is called short message service or SMS. Video conferencing, when two or more people are combined together, are communicating with each other by using the audio visual aids. That is called video conferencing, like we are doing right now. That is the video conferencing. We are doing the communication. We are conversing with each other by using the audio as well as video. Video platforms. It refers to the way of video phones conversation between people, multiple participants. It is a platform where a writer or a group of writers share their views on the individual subjects or any topic, anything. And when many people combine together to do some meeting or to discuss the company's products or discuss the company's budgets, anything. When people are communicating with each other by using the audio and visual aids by using internet, that is called video conferencing. For example, Skype, Zoom, GoToMeeting, Google Meets, all these are the examples of video for doing the video conferencing. Okay, any doubt till now? Yes, any doubt till now? Okay. Next is blogs. Blogs means online diary or journal where users can post any topic, post information or any ideas about views on any topic of his interest, or it is a short form of web blog in which we put the blogs, people read the blogs, we can read the blogs of other people, we can read the ideas and views of other people, we can get the information about various things by reading the blogs of other people, we can participate in the communication by putting some comments, by giving the comments, by reading the comments of others and again further elaborating it or further giving some answers to the comments. So it can form the it can take the form of conversation also. Blogs means it is an organized according to the date. All these information is organized, all the blogs are organized in the chronological order, in the reverse order. So it also refers to online diary or journal where users can post information or their ideas and views from any topic. Microblogging, it is a combination of blogging and internet messaging where users post short messages, or you can say social networking websites where you can, for example, Twitter, that is also where you put some ideas or put some views about the current situation or about anything, about any incident. Then people can communicate with you, people can give messages to you, people can give comment and they can move forward your messages also. So this is called microblogging. Document sharing services, that means it includes all the tools that allows creation and sharing of documents. For example, Google Docs, where you can create the documents, where you can share the documents after creating them. You can send the documents to multiple people. You can share your documents with many people. Okay. Next is, what is computer? What is computer? Who can answer? What is computer? Let's have a communication. It's just one-way communication. I'm saying the things and nobody is giving answer. What is computer?
Ma'am, computer is a machine which can be used for input, output, and ALU and common operated machine. It stands for commonly operated machine, particularly used for trade, research, and education.
Okay, that means computer is a machine that can be used to perform various tasks by getting the input, processing it, and giving the output. It can perform a number of tasks by getting input from the user, processing it, and giving output. Okay, so a computer is an electronic device that can accept the input from the user, process the input, and display the desired output. It performs various operations depending upon the set of instructions. What set of instructions or what kind of instructions we give to computer? According to that, it performs the processes, it does the processing, and gives the result. So according to the definition, there are four functioning parts of the computer, or there are four functions of the computer. That is input, for taking the input, that means giving the information to the user, giving data and instructions to the user. Processes, when the computer do processing or execute or evaluate your in data, and then give the output. After processing, the output is given by the user. For example, a real life example, when we give some numbers to the users to add or to multiply, we can take two numbers, any numbers, 5, 6, performs the addition, that is the processing, and final output given by the computer, that is 11. Similarly, we can take one more daily life example. For example, for making a cup of tea, we need the water, tea leaves, sugar, milk. So all these are the ingredients, are the input that we use while making a cup of tea. Processing, when we boil in a pan, when we make the tea, pouring all ingredients into the pan and boiling it on a gas, that is called processing. And finally, when a cup of tea is ready, we pour it in the mug or any cup, that is your output. Similarly, you can have many other examples from your daily life, because in our daily life, whether we realize or not, every process or every task has three steps: input, processing, or output. The first stage is called input, in which all the data or material is arranged. Second stage is processing, where the actual operation is being performed. And the third stage is where the final result is obtained after the processing. That is the third stage, that is the output stage. All the above three stages merges together and finally known as IPO cycle, that is input, process, output cycle. Every task with or without the use of computer follows this IPO cycle. Every task we do. A computer too follows this cycle, that is it needs certain input, processes the output, and produces the output. Then functions, according to this definition or according to these input, processing, output, we can realize that there are four functions of computer: input, process, output, that is the IPO cycle. Second, computer ka sabse most important advantage, that it can store the data. So that is also the important function of computer. It is included in the important function of computer, that is input, process, output, and storage, so that we can retrieve the data or information as and when required. Input, process, output, storage. Storage is, or the memory is, the storage brain of computer, where we can store information, where the data or information is held, whether permanently or temporarily during the processing. Various storage units which can store the data permanently are CD, DVD, USB, floppy disk, hard disk, memory card, everything. So what is the full form of CD? Anybody? What is the full form of CD?
Compact disk.
DVD?
Digital versatile disk.
Digital versatile disk.
It can be also called super density disk.
Super density disk. Okay, but I ask about the full form only, so you will give the full form. USB?
Universal serial bus.
That is a USB drive. What is the other name of USB storage device? It is
pen drive.
Flash drive. Okay, good. Okay, what is the basic structure of computer? Input devices that gives that give instruction or data to the CPU, that is the processor, that includes processor and main memory. After the processing, the data may passes to the output unit, or it may passes to the secondary storage devices, secondary memory, or the data can be fetched from the secondary memory and passes to the CPU or main memory. And after processing, it goes to the output devices and it may go back to the storage unit. It all depends on the requirement or the instructions given by the user. But the basic structure is input devices giving data and instructions to the CPU, CPU processing it and giving it back to the output devices. Full form of CPU?
Central processing unit.
Okay. And what is the other name of main memory?
Primary memory.
Ek aur hai?
Internal memory.
Okay, main memory, which is in this CPU, that is also called registers. They are also called registers.
Memory unit,
primary memory, internal memory, or registers. Okay, central processing unit, that is also known as the brain of computer. Like our brain controls all the parts of our human body. CPU also controls, it is the brain of computer. It also controls all the components of the computer, all the devices of the computer. And it takes the directs the other parts of the computer how to do or what to do. And it is also known as microprocessor or processor. Various parts or sections of the CPU, ALU, CU, and registers. ALU, arithmetic and logic unit, CU, control unit, and registers. That I just told you, main memory. Main memory also known as registers. The three sections of the CPU works together. They all work together to control the operations of a computer system. They are connected with other major components via specially connecting wires called as system bus. They are buses inside the CPU on the motherboard. They are joined together by using these system bus. ALU, arithmetic and logic unit, responsible for performing the computing functions, or you can say it performs all the arithmetic and logical operations of the computer. That may be addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, or logical operations like less than, greater than, equal to, not equal to. And the result of operations are stored in registers temporarily till they are sent to the output devices or they are sent to the permanent storage devices. Registers, it is short but very fast memory and is used to store data temporarily during the execution of the program. When the program is executing, it temporarily holds the data related to that program or any instruction. Registers are a type of fast computer memory used to quickly accept, store, and transfer data and instructions that are being used by the CPU. CPU, whatever instructions are given by the input devices, they can be stored temporarily in the registers before they passes to the ALU. Similarly, after processing, registers may store the information temporarily before that it passes to the output unit. So, very small fraction of seconds ke liye, they store the data. Control unit. It is also used to direct the entire computer systems to carry out and execute the instructions. It manages the data flow between the various components of the computer system. It controls, like a traffic policeman in any road crossing, you can say that it controls the flow of traffic. Similarly, control unit controls the flow of data and instructions from the input devices, storage devices, and output devices. Between all the components, when the continuously we are typing from the keyboard, clicking with the mouse, we are continuously giving instructions and data to the computer. Control unit is the one that controls the flow, that flow, and passes it to the various concerned devices, concerned sections. ALU performs the actual operations. It manages the data flow, and four steps are very important in order to execute any instruction. CU gets the instruction from memory, that is the registers. CU directs the data to be moved from memory to ALU. ALU performs the calculation. and the result of operation is again stored in the memory, and from memory it goes to output devices. Now, few important terms related to the CPU. Instruction time. Instruction time means in which the instruction is time, in which the instruction is fetched from the memory and stored in the instruction register. That is called instruction time. Execution time is the time that your program takes to execute a particular task after reading the instructions. And the combination of both instruction time and execution time is called machine cycle. Okay. Instruction time means the time which is taken by for reading the instruction, taking the instruction from input device and sending it to the registers. Then execution time is when the program, your program takes to execute the particular task. And together, combine a combination of instruction time and execution time, that is called machine cycle. Okay. So, various advantages and strengths and characteristics or features of computer. Advantages, strengths, characteristics or features of computer. Everybody knows high speed. We can do the calculations. We can, it can perform the various operations at a very, very high speed, which helps the human to finish their task in just a few seconds and can also execute millions of instructions in a few seconds. Computers are much faster as compared to human beings. High accuracy. High accuracy means it always gives the, the calculation with the great degree of accuracy, correct result. Yes, Laksh?
Ma'am, jo exams ho na PT1 ka, wo Google form mein hoga ya written?
Okay, can we discuss it after completing this topic?
Okay,
reliable. Mitansh, what are you doing? Okay, reliable. Reliable computers are more like human beings are not subject to tiredness or boredom or fatigue. That means we can take the work from computer with plenty of hours. Jab tak hum kaam karna chahe, computers pe kaam kar sakte hain. It will never get bored. It will not never get tired, and it will always give the correct result. So that's why we can rely on it. They are more reliable than human beings.
Okay. Iske disadvantages abhi aayenge.
What all of you are talking about? Yes, Pranay. Okay, high storage capacity. High storage capacity means computer can store a very, very large amount of data into its computer memory, into its memory, which is not possible for human being. Computer storage has two parts, that is the primary storage and secondary storage. Primary storage will store the data temporarily during execution, and secondary storage will store the data permanently for a long time. Anytime you can take it back from the computer. That is also called non-volatile memory. Primary memory again has two parts, that is the RAM and ROM. RAM is a volatile part which will store data only at the time of execution. It will lose the data when power goes off or when the program is switched off. And ROM stores the permanent data, that is the BIOS, having the instructions to start the computer, to make the computer ready for working. So only the volatile power memory is RAM, ROM, and all the other secondary storage devices, they are non-volatile memory. Okay, computer can store various files, folders, data, and information, videos, movies, music, and anything that you want to store, which is in digital form. Disadvantages, lack of decision-making power. It cannot take decisions. Like human being, it cannot make decisions on its own. It cannot learn from its mistakes. If we make some mistakes by getting the wrong input, it can make the same mistake. It will not learn from its mistake. It cannot say, yes, previously you had given this wrong instruction. I had calculated the wrong result, you have to give the instruction again, you have to correct the instruction again. It will not say that. So zero IQ means it cannot do anything on its own. It will do whatever instructions are given by human being. चाहे हमें लग रहा है कि वो ऑटोमेटिकली कुछ काम कर रहे हैं, बट दे ऑल आर ड्यू टू द प्रोग्राम्स व्हिच हैव बीन ऑलरेडी गिवन टू कंप्यूटर, व्हिच हैव बीन फीड इनटू द कंप्यूटर ऑलरेडी. नो ह्यूरिस्टिक्स, इफ कंप्यूटर कमिट्स एनी एरर वंस, इफ द सिमिलर सिचुएशन अगेन अराइज, कंप्यूटर विल कमिट द सेम मिस्टेक अगेन एज इट कैन नॉट लर्न फ्रॉम द पास्ट एक्सपीरियंस एज ह्यूमन बींग. जस्ट आई टोल्ड यू दैट. ओके, वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर. Computers can be categorized according to the various things like purpose-wise, operation-wise. Purpose-wise, it is divided into special-purpose computer or general-purpose computer. Special-purpose computers means it can be designed to perform some specific task designed for a particular work only. Instructions can carry out tasks are permanently stored in the machine. Such computers are not versatile in nature because they are used only for a particular task. General purpose computers, they can work on different types of programs. Anybody can use it. Programs are permanently stored. Such computers are very versatile and everybody can use it. Like when you are using the laptops, desktops, mobiles, tablets, all these are the general purpose computers which can be used for any purpose and can be used by anyone. Second is operation wise computers can be classified as analog computers, digital computers and hybrid computers. Analog computers that work with the continuous physical quantities such as temperature, voltage or any frequency which is continuously feeding into the computer. Mostly used in engineering and scientific applications like weather forecasting or processing the data of weather, continuously monitoring the information from the field. Digital computers such as computers, they work with discontinuous data and data is converted into 0 and 1. All the data which works with the digital computer that is converted into zeros and ones. They are fast as compared to analog computers, more accurate, and they can be used for all the business and scientific applications or any personal use also, anyone. Hybrid computer, it is a combination of digital and analog computers, like in hospitals to monitor the patient's vital signs like ECG wagaira, ya jo bhi aapke patient ke वाइटल पार्ट्स को मॉनिटर करने के लिए, उनकी वर्किंग को मॉनिटर करने के लिए वी कैन हैव द कंटिन्यूअस डाटा इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एनालॉग सिग्नल्स एंड वी कैन प्रोसेस दैट एनालॉग सिग्नल्स बाय यूजिंग द डिजिटल डाटा. वी कैन स्टोर द इंफॉर्मेशन एट द डिफरेंट टाइम इंटरवल्स डिजिटली. सो इट इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ बोथ. Types of digital computer, again this digital computer can be further classified as embedded computer, microcomputers, or you can say mini computers, mainframes, and supercomputer. Mind it, you are supposed to learn a few examples for each also. Embedded computers, that is in the form of tiny chip which is embedded in the circuitry of various appliances like washing machine, refrigerators, microwaves, OTGs, in which chip has inserted, which is pre-programmed according to the instructions which are already given to the work. According to the timer setting hai ya unke various operations, order of the various operations which can be performed in the washing machine or in the microwave, they all are the embedded computers. Microcomputers, this is a general computer that we use all of you. Microcomputers means that uses the CPU, processor, microprocessor is there. Processor is used single user systems that can be used for basic operations like in schools, colleges, home, for personal use, offices, stores, everywhere we see they are the microcomputers. One type of digital computer, and it is also known as general purpose computer. Mobiles, handheld computers, portable PCs like laptops, PDAs, tablets, desktop PCs, which will stay at one place, workstations, they are also one of the desktop PCs. Mini computers, they are also known as mid-range servers. Powerful computers, as compared to microcomputers, because they are multi-user computers and can be used in large companies and offices where multiple users can work at the same time using the same processor and giving the instructions and processing and output is done. Can handle more input output devices. That means same CPU, same processor, mid-range servers, they are attached with multiple input and output devices. Computer doesn't mean only a computer screen with keyboard, mouse, and processing device. Computer means processor which can be attached to multiple input devices. It can be fixed inside a computer with a large size, and multiple devices can be attached to it to work on it. And they all can give instructions simultaneously, and mini computer is able to handle them. For example, PTP 11, VAX 7500 Magnum. These are the various examples of mini computers. Mainframe, larger than mini computers. They can handle huge volume of data and information more than mini computers. If we are working with more data, working with more people as compared to the use of mini computer, we will use the mainframe computers. They can support more than 100 users every time. They have more than one processor at the same time and very sophisticated operating system and needed to control and supervise the operations of the main computer. I think, aapke papers honge, whether it is in Google form or PDF form, WhatsApp mein aapko message group mein send ho jayega. Theek hai? It's not sure now. Abhi tak sure nahi hai ki it is PDF or Google form. I will tell you by tomorrow, most probably. Okay? Clear? Okay.